broke my heart the other day. Pusha T. Pusha, I'll never forget. This is like 2004, 2005. I was a senior in high school, right? And the grinding beat came out. Oh my gosh, the grinding beat. Who remembers the grinding beat? Hold on. I just want to play the beat right now. Oh my gosh. Let me just play the grinding beat right now. One second, y'all. Woo. Right? I used to love that beat, right? I used to be in the cafeteria at school, right? Just doing the beat on the table like, woo! Grinding, you know what I speak in the lining. Niggas better stay in line when you see a nigga like me grinding. Grinding, grinding, when you know what you be in the lining. Niggas better stay in line when you see a nigga like me shining. Grinding. So Pusha T and his brother Malice. I said, oh, these niggas is dope. They out of Virginia. Their album was fire. Oh my gosh, yo. Their album was dope. I just love every cut in that goddamn album I listen to. You know what I mean? God damn, it's a new day. My shit. So I always wonder, like, damn, why the fuck would his brother Malice leave the game at the top of their careers? Why? They with Pharrell. They popping out of Virginia. They lit. Why would he leave? And then I see my man. This picture kind of blurry. I probably should have got a better picture than this. But I see my man, Pusha T, sitting alongside Lil Nas X, and they matching with their matching socks. I said, what the fuck?
No, 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 no.
Why would a drug dealer, cocaine whipping gangster rapper be dressed up like that with some shorts above his knees with a matching sock? So obviously they switched socks. So he took one of Lil Nas X socks or vice versa, and they switched socks and they sat next to each other. He's sitting like a girl dressed in women, look like a women's garment over him, and Pusha T sitting there looking mighty comfortable. Make it make sense. That's Pusha T, y'all. Mr. I'm your Pusha. Are you kidding me? I couldn't believe this picture. I said, why the fuck? Why would they do that? Why would they do that? It doesn't make sense to me. Not my boy. Not my boy, right? So, as I'm looking around and I'm scrolling through Instagram, I come across a video of my man, Pusha T. And he looks like he should be like on a cover. Like he would, man, listen. Just certain things that I don't really want my street rappers really participating in. It just looks weird to me. Out of nowhere, my man is, matter of fact, don't let me, I'll let y'all see it. So y'all don't think I'm capping. Let's talk about it. God damn, it's a new day. God damn, but that nigga wanted money.
God damn, they just can't understand or fathom my demeanor. Unapproachable appearance to how I act, the Nina's out of 200.
clips. They say malice to me, he's got love for guns. Between us, Thomas took me for a rapper, huh? Well, that makes me an actor, cause I would rather clap a gun and fuck on them niggas who hate, who wanna be in my shoes, live my life, but can't carry my weight. I understand that the envy is part of the game, but make no mistake, you and I, we are not the same. Nah, bitch, I'm liable to splatter your shit. Light up your world till you start to stagger and shit. Watch how them hollow straight rattle your shit, and I'll leave it to y'all to freestyle and battle and shit. That's not me. I'm already home with the chrome, or I'm playing with the yay, moving 12 for a zone. I'm gone.
God damn, it's a new day, y'all.
Yeah, that nigga sus as hell. That nigga sus as hell.
Sweetie.
Sweet. That nigga look Gleek. Like, that nigga. That nigga like he just drank some Gleeko sauce, my nigga. Rico squad, all my niggas on today. What's up? Salute to the chat, man. Everybody in the chat. I see your man, Fresh Breezy. Granny, long time no see. How you doing? What's poppin', man?
What's poppin' with y'all? Salute to the chat, man.
Salute.
Salute to you, brother, on the panel, man.
What's good
with you, man? And you going in over here, son.
Oh, yeah?
You going in tonight, man. You going in, nigga.
What part exactly, man? Break it down. What part exactly? Talk to me, baby.
Listen. You just exposing a lot of shit. Tonight you becoming, you an x-ray right now. You're a radiologist. You're exposing everything right now. You know what I mean? But you want to know what's crazy? I want everybody to pay attention to one thing he pulled up. He pulled up a picture with Nas X and Pusha T sitting next to each other. And he pulled up. You seen how little Nas X was sitting with his legs crossed?
Child.
With that skirt.
Child. Yeah.
Now let's talk Baphomet talk. Pay attention to that statue. What is he wearing?
Break it down.
He's wearing the same type of dress that everybody in the industry wears. Same legs crossed, same signs. The only thing is he ain't throwing up the symbols, but he's sitting like that. But you gotta understand, remember, he was the key of this. So bad that we don't even hear. I ain't gonna lie, some black people, we got so mad about it, we don't even hear no more about that demonic sneaker he tried to put out.
Oh, yeah. X. I remember that.
We got so, people knew what time it was. Even to the point, a girl that little Nas X used to date back in the day said, that nigga was never gay.
Wow.
But then we didn't know little Nas X was gay. He said, bro, I've been giving y'all hints. So they show his old videos where they zoom in and they see the strip club is really a strip club for niggas.
Damn.
So why did it took this long for y'all to show him to tell us this? The music video, I'm talking about, you had to zoom in deep. It was all digital where it says XX, yada, yada, going and had to blur the rest of it out.
Right, right.
So I come to tell y'all a lot of this shit is set up.
I agree.
Yeah. I mean, like that's all right. The part where I said you was going in, not just this picture, but when he was walking down that motherfucking catwalk.
Woo!
You know what I'm saying? I said to myself, I said, now look, man, like I seen a Philly rapper, do the same thing. I ain't gonna say no names. Maybe one day I'll give it to y'all. This was years ago, early 2000s. The way he was walking on that catwalk for these folks, you know what I mean? It was like, yeah, it brought back memories. I'm like, yo,
I think I know you talking about.
Dudes, man, was
he part of SP?
Nah.
Oh, so it ain't done then.
Nah,
because I know Weston, they started modeling the Rockaway, Chris and Neef, but I don't think they was into that type of shit. I feel like them niggas so real. They said, fuck the industry. I ain't with that shit. And fell back. Them little niggas was in college anyways.
Yeah, it was a lot of niggas that said fuck the industry. But niggas like, I think, like niggas like Pusha T, he trying to reach another audience. So he like, I'm going to act as gay as I could just to reach these people. You know what I'm saying? I think that's what's going on with a lot of these people.
Right. That's crazy.
There's a movie called Time to Kill. A lot of y'all seen the movie Time to Kill, right? Samuel Jackson, what happened to his daughter with the rednecks down in Mississippi, right? You ever seen that?
Yeah, that's one of my favorite movies.
I read the book better than the movie. obviously, you know, it's like that. Now, you remember the part where the lawyer was trying to defend Samuel Jackson against these racist jurors, and he told him to close your eyes and picture you being white, and that little girl was white. You know what I mean? A black, you know what I mean? Now, I want y'all to close your eyes and picture, and I hate to say this, Meek Mill's Pusha T at these all these parties with these gay designers in the background. They got martini glasses on and cheese and wine, and they eating quiche. And these, and you know, some people, even when you talk to a female, you know how niggas get touchy-feely. How you think these gay billionaires were doing to these niggas? Touchy-feely. Hand on your lower back. Flirtation. Look at his face, the baby. He felt that dick in his butt crack. You look at him, he said that, whoa! Save that for the bottom of the yacht type of shit.
Look at that picture worth a thousand words right there.
In little baby's mind right now, he's saying, I know he popped that Viagra.
Jeez.
He got that look at him like, it's going to be a long night.
Wow. Look at this one.
Look at that. Look at that. Look at that hug. It's like, oh my.
Man, he's still hugging me from the back.
And that's Cal Kuzma, right?
That's the second picture.
Is that Cal Kuzma?
I don't know, but I think that's Michael Rubin to the right of him, I believe.
No, I'm talking about the tall one, Cal, the basketball player. Let's talk about, I think that's him.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know who that is.
Well, let me tell you something, man. Like I try to tell everybody, man, at certain funerals you wear all white, you know what I mean? Certain religions, especially the old religion like Ifa Santeria, and certain rituals you do. And it's always a ritual that these guys wear all white yacht and go on the ocean. I'm just saying, man. Y'all pay attention to what these dudes doing. And a lot of them, listen, Diddy got a lot of stuff hitting in his vote. Don't think the people got stuff on him. Don't you think Diddy got shit on them too?
Facts.
Don't think that this nigga just a... You got to understand who Diddy is too and who his dad used to work for.
Yeah.
Out in Mount Vernon, Nick.
Yeah, that was dad a big work, right?
Yeah, dad was used to work with Nicky Barnes.
Yeah.
I heard
Nicky
about
Barnes that. Used to work with my great grandpa, what's his name? Bumpy Johnson. See, that shit go back, but I'm just saying but Diddy, everything that they saying about Diddy, everybody is like Beanie Siegel said. And I can feel it in your air. Man, 95% of his body language, man. Yeah. Even if it's